This is Sharmin Khan from Milky Way Art Design. So today I'm going to work on this 12 inch by 24 inch gallery wrapped canvas, and I'm going to go with a split base. So what I'm going to do, my split base is going to be between black and white. You guys can see that lately I'm doing this a lot. So what I'm going to do to start with, I'm going to use this foam brush. And kind of for the black part, I'm going to color this side to make sure that just in case I have some kind of oof situations. And let me move the thing a little. So so if in case I have some side parts which is not covered, I'm just trying to take care of this to start with. And also sometimes what happens is on the canvas when I'm spinning, and if the sides are wet, the paints usually run very easily. So that's what I'm trying to do. I am going to do the same thing on the opposite side as well. So for this big canvas, I am thinking I would or I might do the modification in two separate parts. The reason is you have to spin your canvas, because otherwise you might get cracks. So to stop getting cracks, you have to spin at the same time. So let me move things around and let me show you what I mean. If I have a pattern on this side and that side, and when I spin, it's going to spread towards that direction. So which at the end, the composition wise, it might not look beautiful. So what I was thinking that I am going to move my canvas and make it off-centered. So what I do is on top of my spinner, I put this 12 inch by 12 inch tile, and on the tile I'm putting the canvas on, and I'm going to put a duct tape here and on the other side, so it will secure the canvas on top of the tile. Then if I spin, it's going to centers of the spin should be here, so my flowers will go this direction, it will not go on the sides. So that's my idea. So give me a second, I have to tape it off. It's very difficult to use a duct tape when you are wearing gloves, so bear with me. So this is one tip, and you can see that I'm trying to do the bare minimum because I just want to secure the canvas while it spins. That's all I'm looking for. So on this side, I'm going to take my gloves off because I cannot tear my tape while I'm wearing the gloves. See this piece, I'm going to put it underneath here so it secures with the canvas and the tile. Both of them are secured together. I'm going to do one on this side and one on here. Since the tile is off-centered, it's randomly spinning which is kind of annoying me, but I will have to work around it. Okay, now I think it's secured. Let me put my glass on again. So now you can see that I have both sides painted. I'm going to work on this side only for now. Once it dries on this side, I will do that side on the in a different day. So today I'm working on this side, and tomorrow I will work on the opposite side. So let's start here. Basically, I'm making sure that I have enough base coat, both black and white, is present underneath the pattern that I'm going to do. Now we need to figure out how many blooms we are going to create. So let's see. Let's do one. If we do five, it'll be too crowded. So probably four. One, two, three, four would be fine. The colors that I am using today, I am going to put down all the names and brands in the description section. I am not going to waste too much time on describing the colors. So let's start. So let's start. This is the second blob. This is the first one. Oops, I think I need to add some water in this one because it's getting thicker. Whenever the paint sits, they tends to get thicker. This is the only pigment that I'm using. I think it's called Mermaid from TLB. So I'll pause for a second. I need some more water on this one. Let me mix it up, then I'll come back. Now that I'm back, I am going to put some the white, titanium white actually, this one from Golden. And I am putting it on the white side. You're wondering white, right? So I'm now making sure that on each puddle there is some titanium white on the black side. Okay, next one. I don't know if you can hear all the winter birds coming from the north. The big goose or geese. They are all here making crazy noises. So at first I was debating, should I put some gold? And the verdict is maybe yes. So this is my Mayan gold. Not too much, but just a drop. You're gonna record that. Give me 1 second. Now I'm going to put cell activator. Okay, let's blow.
Thank you.
So I can see that I need to spread my white a little more because I can see that the flower buds or lines or strings might come this way. So I just did that. Now, let's start with the fun part. You know what? Before I even start spinning, start modifying, I'm going to spin a little just to make sure the paints are in, not clumped up in one spot too much. If they are, they are going to spread or they are going to branch off, and then I can modify them accordingly. Let me zoom out and let me show you how my canvas is spinning. So since the center is on the sides, or the spinner is set on the sides, it's taking a lot of space to spin, and the center is here, you can see. So when the flower spreads, they are going to spread evenly. Now starts the fun part. So first, let's do this. Okay, so that's what we have. Let's do some modification. When I feel like it's too much, I'll stop. If you know me, you know it rarely happens, right? Thank you. I'm going to stop here because I want to keep some of them organic, not going to too much. So I stop, and now I'm going to let it dry, and tomorrow I'll go back and work on the other side. These are the close-ups. And the opposite side, it's drying now. It's going to dry on this side, then I'm going to work on the other side tomorrow. So today is the second day and it has dried. I have a couple of cracks here, but I can always fix those cracks, and other than that it looks fine. So this is my first day's work. This is dried. Now I'm going to work on this side. So I'm just moving my it tends to slide down that way again today. So what I did was on the tile, and this is my spinner. This part is on top of my spinner, and that part is on the other side. So I'm not worried about that side today. Only thing I'm focusing on this is this side. So let me quickly show you how I put on my base coat, and from there we will start. Now let's start. Again, like before, I'm going to make four puddles, starting with four different colors.
What's that?
Okay, so let's spin. So, always try to find a tentacle or something. See, I just blew a little here, so that way what will happen, I will create something like this here. Thank you.
So far what I have right now is I think I'm going to stop here because it turned out really pretty and I'm really happy with the results. Very rarely I get happy or excited about a piece, and this is one of those pieces that I'm really happy about it. So I am going to stop now.
Also, I wanted to show you that this is where, as I was blowing on this side, it splattered over there and it came all the way up here. So with this little foam brush, I'm going to go and fix it. Hopefully it'll be taken care of because that side is dried already. So there we go. Let me bring you down. So this is the total composition up front. That side is dried and this side is wet. I will wait to let it dry, then I'll show you the entire thing. Thank you so much for joining me today and hanging out with me. I hope you enjoyed this piece and I'm really excited about this one to share with you. So until next time, bye.